If it's not a hit, switch. Before I started CD Baby, I spent 12 years as a professional musician doing lots of different things. I had a recording studio and I was producing people's records and I was playing on people's records. I was in a circus for 10 years. I tried starting a booking agency. I tried running a five-piece funk band, a two-piece coffee house duo, a two-piece thing called The Professional Pests, where I was running around inside a black costume. I did my solo show. I tried a lot of stuff. I think I even did a record label, Artificial Records. It's kind of fun. But nothing really went very well. Everything I was doing for 12 years felt like a ridiculous amount of work just to get anywhere. It felt like I was always fighting uphill battles against locked and slamming doors, right? Like, nothing was easy. Everything was hard. But then I started CD Baby, and it was this little hobby, like I said, and it just took off. All of a sudden, it wasn't like I was trying to build the business. I wasn't trying to fight any uphill battles. It was like everything was rolling downhill, meaning like it was more about just like managing the growth. Like, more and more people kept coming my way, and all I was doing is just saying yes. So it felt a little bit like writing a hit song. And here's what I mean by that. So for many years, as a songwriter, I would read interviews with hit songwriters. And a lot of them would say that their big hit song that everybody knows was really just a little throwaway song. That, say, they had finished recording the entire album, and then there was this one goofy little song that they were just singing on the tour bus or something. And the producer said, come on, let's hit record on that song, it can't hurt. And the band didn't want to, but then they said, all right, and they hit record. And that becomes the number one hit. And these songwriters are often stunned by this, saying like, I wrote 100 songs, and who knows why that one is more successful. Sometimes it's due to circumstances totally out of their control. Like, this one song that they wrote years ago suddenly was heard by somebody who does the music for a TV show, and it was the season finale and the closing credits, and now they want to use their song, and all of a sudden, that's a big hit song. But the lesson learned is that, looking back at my previous 12 years and all the stuff I did that was so difficult, I think my advice for my younger self, and therefore for you, is that I was doing lots of things that people just weren't into. And now I've felt the difference. When you do something that people are really into, you'll know it because you get this reaction. Like, people go, oh my God, yes, I love this. Can I pay you for this? I want to be your first customer. I want to, you know, people are actually opening up their wallets to pay you because they are so excited about what you're doing. It feels effortless. But on the other hand, when you get this kind of lukewarm response from people, like, even if, say, you are have a business idea and you tell people and they go, yeah, sounds pretty good. Let me know if it happens. That's kind of a polite no. That doesn't mean they're interested. So now that I've felt the difference between the two, my lesson for myself and you is that when you're spending time on these ideas that people just aren't into, let it go. Like, if people aren't into it, stop and do something else. Another songwriter comparison, spent a lot of years in LA and New York and some in Nashville, where you would see some songwriters who wrote one song. Like, maybe it was the first song they ever wrote, or maybe it was a song they wrote for their wife or something like that. But they get obsessed with this one song, and they spend years trying to bring this one song around the music industry, and nobody's into it, and they try to keep pushing this one song. And it always felt really kind of pathetic, the people that just kept pushing this one song that people aren't into. Whereas on the other hand, most successful songwriters seem to just churn them out. It's like every week they're writing the best song they can at the time, and they just keep going. So if somebody's not into the song they wrote last week, whatever, there's more. So my advice for entrepreneurs is to be more like those kind of songwriters, that hopefully you have other ideas. Of course you have other ideas. So keep pushing these other ideas. Meaning, like, if you're doing something that people just aren't into, let it go and just try something else. Don't be like these songwriters that just push one song that people aren't into. There's this great quote from Warren Buffett, the investor. He said that in all their years and all the different investment opportunities that pass through their desk, and of course they all pass through his desk, he says, we never invest in anything unless it feels like a real home run. So I think that, you know, you have lots of business ideas. Try them out, but don't get too stuck on anyone unless you could tell, like, it's a real home run. Everybody's really into it. So if people aren't loving what you're doing, stop. Don't persist. Don't push it. When you've got something great, you'll know. People will be freaking out over it. If people say anything less than, oh my God, yes, I want to pay for this, then stop and write a new song. The lesson learned the hard way is that success comes from persistently improving and inventing, not from persistently pushing what's not working.